the need of the hour today. And exactly that's why former Congress President Shri Rahul Gandhi came forward yesterday and addressed the media, is to point out that India's economy is sinking. The NPA minus coronavirus were already 9 lakh crores. 7,75,000 crore rupees of debts have been waived for corporates by this government over the last 5.5 years. The stressed assets of the bank are 16.5 lakh crores. So forget the impact of the coronavirus. The day 31st March comes and passes, on 1st of April, all these debts will go into the NPA category. Think about a situation where countries' NPAs are in the realm of over 20 lakh crores. What will happen to the state of such an economy? And that day is not very far, for 31st March is coming. Also, the way stock market has crashed over last 72 hours, almost 18 lakh to 20 lakh crores of investors' money has been wiped out. The State Bank of India, which is now an investor bank to save private banks which are sinking, its share price has dropped from 327 per share to 212 per share. That's a drastic reduction of over 100 rupees. That's almost a 30% reduction in price. The way India's exports have gone are on a nosedive, and even imports are on a nosedive, shows a classic slowdown. It's not only a stagflation now, it's actually going into a serious recession. India is passing through serious economic recession. But the finance minister refuses to even acknowledge it, much less address it. And Prime Minister has a mum attitude to economic issues plaguing the country. Inflation rate today is more than the deposit rate in the bank. Inflation is 6.58%. Savings bank interest rate is 3%, and FD rate is 6%. So that means nobody should, even having an FD, will be able to survive. The interest rate in the bank is half of the inflation rate. But does finance minister even understand it, much less acknowledge it? The unemployment is almost touching 7.78%, which is a 60-year high, or perhaps highest ever. India's rupee almost touched 75 rupees 16 paisa, unless and government pumped in money. It is still trading today at 74 rupees 40 paisa to a dollar, which is perhaps amongst the lowest ever. So India is in a state of deep recession. And these are issues of life and livelihood that government must address.